and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to hear the contrite of heart, Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
You came to call sinners, Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Keep your family, O Lord, schooled always in good works, and so comfort them in your protection here, as to lead them graciously to the gifts on high. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The people of Judah and the citizens of Jerusalem said, "Come, let us contrive a plot against Jeremiah. It will not mean the loss of instruction from the priests, nor of counsels from the wise, nor of message from the prophets. And so, let us destroy him by his own tongue. Let us carefully note his every word. Heed me, O Lord, and listen to what my adversaries say. Must good be repaid with evil, that they should dig a pit to take my life? Remember that I stood before you to speak in their behalf, to turn away your wrath from them." The word of the Lord. Response, O your Son, save me, O Lord, in your kindness.
Save me, O Lord,
in your kindness. You will free me from the snare that they set for me, for you are my refuge. Into your hands I commend my spirit. You will redeem me, O Lord, O faithful God.
Save me, O Lord,
in your kindness. I hear the whispers of the crowd that frighten me from every side, as they consult together against me, plotting to take my life.
Save me, O Lord,
in your kindness. Was my trust is in you, O Lord. I say, you are my God. In your hands is my destiny. Rescue me from the clutches of my enemies and my persecutors.
Save me, O Lord,
in your kindness. Gospel acclamation. Glory to you, Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory to you,
Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will have the light of life.
Glory to you,
Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. As Jesus was going up to Jerusalem, he took the 12 disciples aside by themselves and said to them on the way, "Behold, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be handed over to the chief priests and the scribes, and they will condemn him to death and hand him over to the Gentiles to be mocked and scourged and crucified. and he will be raised on the third day. Then the mother of the sons of Zebedee approached Jesus with her sons and did him homage, wishing to ask him for something. He said to her, "What do you wish?" She answered him, "Command that these two sons of mine sit one at your right and the other at your left in your kingdom." Jesus said in reply, "You do not know what you are asking. Can you drink the chalice that I'm going to drink?" They said to him, "We can." He replied, "My chalice you will indeed drink, but to sit at my right and at my left, this is not mine to give, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared by my Father." When the ten heard this, they became indignant at the two brothers. But Jesus summoned them and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over to them, and the great ones make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be so among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you shall be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you shall be your slave. Just so the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord. I invite you to join me in reflecting on today's word, beginning with the psalm of today, which says, "Save me, O Lord, in your kindness." Save me, O Lord, in your kindness. Is a servant of God who is in trouble, who is in suffering, who is discouraged because of God's word. And where does he turn his head? Not to fight with the people he's serving, but he turns back to God. He turns back to Jesus, asking and seeking his protection, asking and seeking his strength, how to deal with this situation he's facing. In fact, the two readings of today, the first reading and the gospel, they underscore the sufferings of the servants of God. Sometimes they are discouraged, disappointed. Sometimes they feel as if what they are doing is not yielding anything good. Jeremiah, in the first reading today, he asked God, "Can good be repaid by evil? I'm here for the good. I'm here on your behalf, God. Can I receive evil in return?" And what does he do? He prays for deliverance from God. He never quarreled with his people. He never fought back with his people. His battles became the battles of God. In the gospel of today, also underscores the suffering of Jesus as Son of Man. Remember, I'm going to Jerusalem. It's not for victory, but I'll be scourged, I'll be persecuted, I'll be crucified, and they will kill me. But then at the end of the suffering, there is good news. On the third day, I rise. And when he was telling about this, what happened to his disciples? They did not mind about his suffering. They were minding about only the positions of leadership, who is greatest among us. Jesus teaches us servant leadership. Our greatness is that when we are able to serve others amid these whole challenges of life. In fact, the greatest temptations of God's ministers today is living a double life. They want to have high, prestigious positions, to be honored. Another temptation is for the power and the glory, the way we have just seen from the mother of these two disciples. This mother thought that her children are the best, are the best among the apostles. Let one sit on your right and another one on the left. And this is the desire of every parent. This is the desire of every mother. You'll be proud when your children are recognized in the community, in the society as the best. For her, she just promoted them. Let one be the prime minister and another one be the vice president in your kingdom. She underlooked the rest, but Jesus said, what you're asking, you don't know. What you're asking, you are not aware of my mission. My mission is of service. It's not that one of being served. I came to serve and not to be served. Servant leadership. In fact, today again, we remember that Jesus teaches us that the criteria for greatness in God's kingdom is that of humility, humbleness. Look in the life of the church, the history of the church. Those who have been honored as saints, they were just servants. I always like giving the example of St. Francis of Assisi, St. Teresa of Calcutta. These were people who were there for service, in humble, with humility of heart. They were there to feed the poor. They were there to give their life to the others. Are you prepared to drink the cup? Jesus asked the disciples, John and James. Are you prepared to drink the cup? Yes, we are ready. He said, the cup you will drink, the cross you will carry, but that one entering the kingdom is granted by my Father in heaven. Jesus did not condemn James and John for being so ambitious. Rather, he asked a very important question. Can you bring the chalice I'm to drink? There is nothing wrong with aspiring for heaven. You aspire more. Come every day. That's the chalice you are drinking. Aspire more. However, the book of Sirach chapter 2 says, my child, when you come to serve the Lord, prepare yourself for an ordeal. That is the chalice. But the chalice Jesus was talking about was the cross. Yet without waiting for the man to respond, John and James responded, we are ready. We are able to drink it. In baptism, we also pronounce the same thing. Yes, I can. And in confirmation, we strengthen that yes. Are we still taking up the chalice of baptism? Are we still having that fire in us? Are we still having that aspiration for great positions in heaven? To be Christian, we cannot escape painful ordeals, such as those of Jeremiah in the first reading. Jesus prophesies, saying, indeed, an hour is coming when those who kill you, who persecute you, will think that by doing so, they are offering worship to God. Many people are talking about you even coming to church every morning in this weather. Many people are not happy with you. They are talking, are you going to follow their opinion? Follow your conviction of following Christ. Drinking the cup does not guarantee seats in home of honor, but serving others does. That's what Jesus invited us to serve others. Jesus is asking you and me to be always at the service of others. All who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. If you find yourself in a position of service, consider it a privilege. Reflecting on the life of Jesus, St. Paul says, let the same mind be in you that was in Christ, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard his equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant. He humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and gave him the name which is above every name. There is more honor in being a servant than being served by others. Let us continue in the Lord today, that we become available, that we become humble in serving others than looking for places of honor, which sometimes compromise our Christian witness. Oh God, teach me to find joy in being a servant, more especially among the weak, through Christ our Lord. Together, let us stand and present our needs to the Father, who sees every need for the Church. May God use this season of Lent to foster in us a great commitment to living as disciples of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
for the world. May the Lord bring forth compassionate people willing to assume elected and appointed leadership positions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
for those oppressed by any evil in the world. May Christ bring about justice and sources of healing for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
for this worship community. May the Lord help us grow in humility by serving others in the name of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
for all who have died. May they live eternally in the light of heavenly glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
for all those prayers lying deep in our hearts, we present them to the Lord in silence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
everlasting God, hear the prayers of your servants and grant what will help us grow closer to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the
Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is true, right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disorderly affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternal endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy,
Lord of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. O Mass on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God,
now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you enter my home,
but I can see the world. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord our God, that what you have given us as the pledge of immortality may work for our eternal salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. And enjoy the rest of your day. Saint Michael, the Archangel,
pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel,
pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Pro round the world.